Hi friends, it is Thankful to Live and I am going to be making the meat for empanadas. So this is how to make empanadas part one. So the part one would be just how to make the meat, and then on part two I will actually show you how to assemble them. So I'm going to start very easily. We will need ground beef. This one is 93%, so it doesn't have a lot of fat, so I don't have to drain it or any of that stuff. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to brown the meat. So you turn on your stove, as always, me with my high setting. And so you're going to brown your meat. And that's going to be the first thing. Because I'm using the caldero, I'm going to get some oven mittens because I don't want to get burnt. It's just, man, this is burnt. Or ugly looking, should I say. And this one is too. I think I used them for grilling, so now they have this thing on them. So I need to go shopping for mittens. Anyways, so you brown your meat. This one, I love it because it's, it doesn't have a lot of fat in it, so that's great. Let me turn it down so you can see. And then while the meat starts browning, I'm going to show you some of the ingredients that I don't think I'm going to use this. I'm going to go ahead and skip on that. Because what I was thinking was to go ahead and fry the sofrito in it first and then brown. But I kind of want to brown it first to kind of see how much fat it has. Because I may or may not drain it based on how much fat I see on the meat. So while that is browning, I went ahead and got some sofrito. I was out of sofrito. This is homemade sofrito seasoning from the local Latin store, the local Spanish store. And I'm always looking at the ingredients to make sure it doesn't have MSG or food coloring or anything like that. I saw this other one that was on sale, but when I looked at the ingredients, it had yellow and blue dye. I'm like, why? Why would you do that? So anyway, I didn't buy it. I bought this one because it's fresher. It doesn't have any additives. And then I'm gonna use some of this salsa. You can use any type of salsa, but I'm using this one. I think we got it at Publix and it's organic and it's medium salsa. So it's not really, really, really hot, even though if you like hot, you can buy the hot salsa and make your empanadas a little spicier. And then I found this sazon with no MSG, which was the main reason why I wasn't using the Goya sazon. So I love it because I like using sazon for my meals. And this one has coriander and annatto. And annatto is something to make it have a nice red color to it. Okay? So, oh great, I just dropped a spoon. We'll get another one. So we're browning the meat on high, because you know me, I like to cook on high. Why waste time? Okay, so we've been at it for almost 4 minutes and the meat is almost completely browned. Got another, maybe another minute to go. And then we're going to start pouring ingredients. Yeah, I don't see much fat on this meat at all. So I'm going to go ahead and start pouring ingredients here soon. Awesome blossom. Yep. This is going to be delicious. All right, let me get a spoon. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pour the sofrito. Yeah. Give it a couple more minutes to get to brown it. There you go. Mm-hmm. And this meat, we're making it for our empanadas that we're gonna make. And it's gonna be delicious. Oh, you know what I forgot was olives, but not everyone in my family likes olives, so I'm gonna leave them out. But if you want, you can add olives to your recipe. So I'm gonna put 1, 2, full tablespoons of sofrito in there because I want lots of flavor. Lots and lots of flavor. And then I'm gonna rinse my spoon. And I'm gonna put 1-2 tablespoons of salsa. Medium salsa or whatever you choose. And I am going to use sazon. I'm gonna pour the whole packet in there. And I'm going to add about this much Himalayan salt. I would say it's about half a teaspoon of salt. And a little bit of black pepper. And I have some oregano that I just dried. So I'm gonna pick some oregano from here. I have some oregano. I'm just gonna crunch it up. Crunchy, crunchy. And put it in there. There you go. And voila. Oh, I hear my phone ringing and I am so not gonna go get it. I could chop some more or mash some more garlic and put it in there, but I'm not going to because there's garlic in the sofrito, but I am gonna add a little bit of garlic powder just in case there's not enough because we love garlic in this house. And this is it. This is the mix. This is the meat for the empanadas, and you're gonna let it cook for about 15-20 minutes and then let it cool down. And when it cools down, I'm going to show you how to put together the empanadas with a special ingredient that I will show you on part 2. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day.